When you hear the word ribosome, what do you think of? It might sound like a fancy instrument. It might even sound like a disease. What about a scary mythical creature or an exotic fruit? Well, you'll be pleased to know that a ribosome is none of those things, and we actually all have ribosomes in our bodies. And now that you know that you've got ribosomes inside you, you probably want to know, what is a ribosome? And that's a question I'm happy to answer. Let's get started. A ribosome is an organelle, an extremely specialized subcellular structure that has a very particular duty to perform in the cell. Ribosomes are found in just about every organism, both prokaryotic, with no nucleus, and eukaryotic, with a true nucleus. Although ribosomes are present in both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells, they live in slightly different locations. In prokaryotic cells, ribosomes roam freely in the cytoplasm, and they're called 70S ribosomes. The S refers to a Svedberg unit measuring sedimentation coefficient. For biological macromolecules and cell organelles like ribosomes, the sedimentation rate is typically measured as the rate of travel in a centrifuge tube subjected to high G-force. In eukaryotic cells, their ribosomes, which are called 80S ribosomes, can roam free or also hang out on the endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so ribosomes are organelles found in cytoplasm or on the endoplasmic reticulum. But what the heck do they do? The ribosome's duty is simple. Help the cell make the proteins it needs to function. The location of the ribosome within the cell helps dictate what kind of protein it makes. For example, ribosomes can attach to the endoplasmic reticulum, making it what we call a rough endoplasmic reticulum. Ribosomes on a rough endoplasmic reticulum are versatile and can make proteins that can be used inside or outside the cell. Talk about a jack of all trades. So, what have we learned so far? We've learned that ribosomes are organelles, that they are found in all kinds of cells, just in different places, and their main function is to help make protein. So great, now it's time to put a face to the name. What is a ribosome made of, and what does it look like? Although we know that a ribosome is an organelle, that doesn't really tell us much about what it's made of. After all, there are a million different recipes for different organs and structures in the body. Lucky for us, ribosomes have a very specific recipe that we can share. 1/3 sugar, 1/3 spice, and 1/3 everything nice. Just kidding. The real secret ribosome recipe is more like around 2/3 ribonucleic acid or RNA and 1/3 protein to make up the difference. Using this proportion of RNA and protein, ribosomes are made in the nucleolus of the nucleus and released to fulfill their ribosomal duties. A ribosome's structure is composed of two main RNA protein complexes called subunits. There is a larger subunit and a smaller subunit, both with a similar, well, blob/raisin/nugget shape, and both composed of ribosomal RNA and ribosomal proteins. Both subunits exist separately and stay separated until they get a cell phone call, pun intended, that they're needed for protein production. Now, remember the 70S and 80S ribosomes that we mentioned before for prokaryotes and eukaryotes? Well, we can actually break this down a little further now that we know about the two subunits. Prokaryotes, the organisms with 70S ribosomes, have smaller subunits of 30S and bigger subunits of 50S ribosomes. The 30S subunit contains 16S RNA and 21 proteins, where the 50S subunit contains 5S RNA and 31 proteins. Eukaryotes, the organisms with 80S ribosomes, have smaller subunits of 40S and larger subunits of 60S. The 40S subunit consists of 18S rRNA and 30 proteins, whereas the larger 60S subunit contains three types of rRNA molecules, 28S rRNA, 5.8S rRNA, and 5S rRNA. This subunit also contains proteins, 40 of them. After a better understanding of what each subunit structure is, how do they join together? When the ribosome is called for protein production, the smaller subunit finds the messenger RNA in the cell. And after they get together, they join onto a larger subunit. Basically, a ribosome that is primed for protein production looks like a messenger RNA sandwich. Big top bun, mRNA fillings, and a small bottom bun. A terrible sandwich, really. But a sandwich with an important protein building function nonetheless. Much like how ribosome subunits exist on their own, the subunits once again break apart into their individual subunits after they have completed their job. On our ribosome diagram on the screen, you can now see two new players in the protein synthesis game: tRNA or transfer RNA, and amino acids. Both tRNA and amino acids play an integral role in translation, which is one of the main steps in protein synthesis. Translation consists of three main steps, the perfect routine to make proteins. The first step, initiation. This is when the ribosome sandwich gets made. tRNAs bring amino acids into the mix, and those amino acids are joined together in the growing peptide chain. The next step, elongation. And this is when, well, things elongate. The peptide chain keeps growing and growing as more amino acids are invited to the party. The final step, termination. This is when the protein party is over. The ribosome sandwich breaks apart and the new protein is released into the wild. And by wild, I mean the designated part of the cell that it goes to. Isn't science beautiful? Oh yeah. And this is it for our videos on ribosomes. Thanks for sticking around to learn about them. Click on the next video to continue learning more about the human body. Like the video if you want to see more of these on my channel. And subscribe if you don't want to miss the next upload. I'll see you next time.